Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Richard Reti and Akiba Rubinstein. This game was played in Vienna in 1922. Reti had white pieces and he started with e4. Akiba Rubinstein played e5, knight to f3, knight to c6, bishop to b5, the Spanish game. Asking a question, bishop to a4, knight to f6, attacking the pawn on e4. Richard Reti castled kingside. Bishop to e7, not taking the pawn. White to move. Rook to e1 is the most played move. Richard Reti played queen to e2, intending rook to d1, perhaps. b5, bishop to b3, d6, c3. So if knight to a5, bishop to c2. Castling. d4, bishop to g4, pinning the knight. White to move, rook to d1 is the most played move in this position. Richard Reti played d5, gaining the space on the board and closing the center. Knight to a5, bishop to c2, c6, d takes on c6, knight takes on c6, a4. Black to move, of course, not taking the pawn. b4. Knight from b to d2, queen to c7, bishop to d3, a5, knight to c4, b takes on c3, b takes on c3, and white has a weak pawn on c3. Knight to d8, knight to e3, bishop takes knight, queen takes bishop, queen takes on c3, and Rubinstein is a pawn up, but Reti allowed that. Reti was actually setting up a trap. Knight to f5, allowing black to take on a1, but Rubinstein didn't fall for it. He played queen to c7. Let's take it back and see what the trap is. If queen takes rook, then knight takes on e7 check, and after king to h8, bishop to g5, discovered attack on the queen. After the queen moves to a safe spot, bishop takes on f6, and black is advised not to take the bishop, because if g takes on f6, queen takes on f6, checkmate. Back to our game. Rubinstein wisely played queen to c7. Bishop to a3. White pieces are better placed. Or maybe that's just an optical illusion. What do you think? Knight to e6. Queen to g3, eyeing the pawn on g7. Rook from f to d8. Rook from f to c1. Queen to a7. Rook to c6, attacking the weak pawn on d6. How to defend the pawn? What would you do in this position if you had white pieces? If black plays knight to e8, passively defending the pawn, then rook to a6, and after queen to b7, rook to b1. Back to our game. Instead of defending the pawn, Rubinstein played bishop to f8. White to move. How should white take on d6? With the knight or with the bishop? Instead of taking on d6, rook from a to c1 was played. Let's take it back. Rubinstein set up a little trap of his own. This was the trap. If knight takes on d6, then queen to d4. And black probably wins. And what else? If bishop takes on d6, bishop takes on d6, rook takes on d6, rook takes rook, knight takes on d6, again queen to d4, forking two pieces. Back to our game. Rook from a to c1 was played. Knight to h5, attacking the queen. Queen to g4. g6. Bishop to c4. The knight goes back to f6, attacking the queen. Queen to h4. Optically, white pieces are better placed. But Rubinstein was defending superbly. Knight to e8. It is white to move, And this is the critical moment. Knight to e3 was played. Let's take it back. Bishop takes knight on e6 should have been considered. And after f takes on e6, knight to h6 check, then bishop takes on h6, queen takes on h6. It is about equal. But Reti was not happy with an equal position. He wanted to have more, and he didn't see how he can make progress from this position. Back to our game. In this position, instead of bishop takes knight, knight to e3, but then the knight jumped to d4. This is a very nice outpost for the knight. And now you can see why white should have taken on e6. The game continued. Rook to a6, queen to d7, knight to d5, rook takes rook, bishop takes rook, rook to b8, bishop to c4, king to g7. Well, queen takes on a4 is also a good move, and white can't punish this pawn grab. Back to our game. King to g7, f4, queen takes pawn on a4, also attacking the bishop. And where is the bishop going? F takes on e5 was played. Queen takes bishop, rook to f1, queen to c5, knight to e3, rook to b7, queen to d8, attacking the knight. How to defend the knight? What would you do? Rubinstein played the knight to c6. If the knight moves to c7, then rook takes on f7 check. Back to our game. Knight to c6 attacking the queen. Queen takes knight. Queen takes knight check. King to h1. Black played the move when white resigned, and the move is knight takes on e5. In this position, Reti resigned. Why? Well, he was glad that it was all finished. He felt like he was fighting a brick wall. For the entertainment purpose, I will show you a few more moves. Let's say queen to a8 attacking the rook. Rook to b2. The bishop on c4 is under attack. If queen to d5, then rook to d2 attacking the queen, and even daring white to take on f7. If rook takes on f7, then with check, then king to h6, and after rook comes back to defend the first rank, rook takes on d5. And let's go back. Instead of taking on f7, if queen goes to b5, still defending the bishop, queen takes on e4 with a double threat. And after rook to g1, queen takes bishop on c4 is winning. But I like this line. Knight to g4, threatening knight to f2, smothered checkmate. After h3, check, king to h2, queen to f4, check, g3, knight to g4, discovered check, king to h1, black to move and to checkmate in one. Rook to h2, checkmate. What do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.